The National Herald issue has dominated news headlines over the past week, and we are joined by senior legal brains of the Congress Party and also former law minister, Mr. Kapil Sibal. Mr. Kapil Sibal, the Congress Party has called this a political vendetta. How do you prove the charge of political vendetta against the government?
See, it's a political vendetta for several reasons. Number one, Mr. Jaitley, on August 5, 2014, when he was the Minister for Finance, gave an interview to a TV news channel that this particular deal involves a young Indian company which is taking over the property of AGL. Now, for a finance minister to say that while the matter is pending in court means he wants to give a message through the He wants to give a message by the government to the income tax department and other agencies to go after us.
Okay,
number one.
So you're clarifying that the message is to the government's income tax department and the enforcement directorate, or are you saying it's a message to the courts?
No, not to the courts. Because he didn't talk about criminality. He talked about this deal sucks. I mean, he didn't use that language, but that's what he meant. And even now, just a couple of days ago, he said the same thing. Now the matter is pending in court, and you know, Subramanian Swamy says in court, much before the Congress Party receives any notice from the Income Tax Department, that soon we'll be getting notices of the Income Tax Department. Now Swamy is not part of the government. How does he know that we are going to get notices from the Income Tax Department? And the ED, who is appointed and closes the case on the enforcement side, the next ED comes and reopens it. Now, what does it show to you that Swamy and the government are working hand in glove? And this is not the only case. Remember, they are targeting Chidambaram for no reason at all. Again, through Swamy.
But the finance minister has, in an interview to me, told me that there was a raid conducted on persons unrelated to Mr. Chidambaram. But the books of account were found in premises of Mr. Chidambaram's family.
Correct. So therefore they are correct. So therefore they are targeting Chidambaram.
No, so it's a case that's going on.
Let's come back to National Herald. Because I want to answer your question. What about the fact that Veerbhadra Singh, on the day when his daughter's marriage is taking place, the CBI goes and seeks to arrest him? Has it happened in the history of this country?
But what again, about to that, Mr. Jaitley has said in an interview to me just two days ago, he has said that this function was a house function, home function, where only a handful of people knew, none of the cabinet ministers of the Congress Party of Veerbhadra Singh's own government had any inkling about a family function. How was the Income Tax Department supposed to know that there was a family
when they
function?
Reached, when they reached there, they knew there was a function on.
It was in the temple.
No, they knew it. They knew they were...
So they should have gone back.
You are not talking for Mr. Jaitley, are you?
No, I'm asking the question raised by him. Because you're saying political vendetta, the political vendetta is from the government.
I'm answering him. Okay. Please ask Mr. Jaitley how many times any person charged for disproportionate assets has been arrested. Because disproportionate assets is a case involving tax returns. All the tax returns are already with them. What the assets are, they know. What is there to arrest somebody for the purposes of finding out through custodial interrogation? Except that it's a vendetta.
So who has been arrested?
They wanted to arrest him.
So Veerbhadra Singh hasn't been arrested.
They went there to arrest him. They told the court, we want his arrest. See, you don't know all the facts. Now then the issue of Modi Gate comes up in parliament and other issues. Kuwait, Rajasthan also come up in parliament. Sachin Pilot is targeted. Ashok Gehlot is targeted in some scam. And when it comes to Amit Shah's acquittal, no appeal by CBI. When it comes to the Babri Masjid, since 1990s, the case is pending for CBI is doing nothing about it. When it comes to fake encounters, you reinstate them. CBI says there's no case against them. So when it comes to the Congress Party, you persecute and prosecute them and use CBI. And when it comes to your own people,
okay, Mr. Kapil Sibal, let's go point by point on the National Herald case. On the National Herald case, the question that has been raised again, I'll say the finance minister, because he's written a blog yesterday.
I'm a little sorry that it's a bit inappropriate for him to do that. He's the finance minister, remember? Agencies work under him. But anyway,
he's written a blog and he says in his blog the rupees 90 crore debt is assigned to a Section 25 company for a paltry amount of rupees 50 lakhs.
Mm-hmm.
Tax exempted money effectively gets transferred to a real estate company.
Mm-hmm.
The real estate company now acquires 99% of the shareholding
right,
of the former newspaper company.
Right.
Effectively, the Section 25 company, substantially controlled by the leaders of the Congress party,
right,
now owns all the properties acquired for a newspaper publication.
You know, Mr. Jaitley is a minister of corporate affairs also. He should know as a matter of law, and he's also a lawyer, that when Young Indian acquires 99% shareholding of AGL, Young Indian doesn't own the assets of AGL.
Okay, then let's
assets
go to...
Assets of AGL were owned by AGL, and even after 99% shareholding by Young Indian, continue to be owned by AGL. So the basis of his blog is legally flawed, unfortunately.
Okay, but look at the High Court judgment, and this is the judgment by Justice Sunil Gaur, somebody that the Congress party wanted continuing in that position.
Because it was partered, not for any other reason.
Because it was...
Partered, the matter was partered, so that's why.
But the entire issue came up before another judge, you yourself...
It was not partered before the other judge. You know, in the rules of the court, a judge who is hearing the matter for 1.5 years cannot suddenly send it to another judge when he says it's a partered matter.
Okay, so whichever way you went.
So I don't say I wanted, it's the law, it's the rules of the court.
Okay, so you went it. The court had assigned the case to another judge.
Cannot,
you wanted
under
back.
That's why they went sent it back, because they realized they'd made a mistake.
Okay,
the rules.
So that judge, what does he say? He
mm-hmm.
says Sonia Gandhi and her son Rahul Gandhi own 38% each of the shares of Young Indian
Correct.
Company.
Correct.
The debt which Associated Journals Limited owed to the Congress to that transfer to the Young Indian,
right,
which was formed in November 2010.
Right.
He also goes on to say, pertinently, in December 2010,
yes,
AGL increased its share equity by allotting a large chunk
right.
of its shares
These
to Young Indian.
These are all facts known to everybody. So what is it? What is it for? What's the offense?
The offense, as per the court.
Tell me where the court says, what is the offense?
The court says, after having considered the entire case in its proper perspective, the
right.
court finds no hesitation to put it on record that the modus operandi adopted by petitioners
right.
to take control of Associated Journals via special purpose vehicle, Young Indian, particularly when its main persons in the Congress party are the same, evidences a criminal intent.
What is that criminal intent? Under what law?
That's stated by the court.
I want to know which is that section.
So that answer, can Narendra Modi give you?
Can? I'm not asking Narendra Modi. I'm saying
because
you are... That I've answered separately. That's nothing to do with AGL. Since you've quoted that judgment, please find in this judgment what section of the penal code has been violated. Please tell me.
The point is,
please,
if you want an answer to this...
I'm not wanting... You're putting to me.
No, I'm putting to you from the judgment of the High Court.
No,
I'm not a judge. I'm not a lawyer.
The judgment of the High Court may be right, may be wrong. You said that the judge has said this. I want to know. The judge has also said later in the paragraph, which species of offences have been committed, I cannot say. Should I quote you that?
So
even the judge does not say which species of offences have been committed. Then the judge also says, I do not know prima facie whether any offence has been committed or not. That also the judge says. So you must have read the entire judgment. Quote the entire judgment.
Mr. Kapil Sibal, my simple point to you is
yes.
that if the judgment of the Delhi High Court observes a few things
yes.
and raises questions
yes.
and says that you have to be summoned and...
So fine,
and
we are going there.
The point is that the redressal to this will be in a court of law.
Absolutely.
It cannot be in the parliament.
But who's saying we are seeking a redressal in parliament?
But that's what your entire paralysis in parliament
Certainly
is
not.
All about.
Certainly not. Nothing to do with this. See, these are two separate issues. The legal battle will be fought in courts, and the political battle will be fought in parliament.
But Rahul Gandhi says that there is a political vendetta, 100%.
I'm giving you the reason.
And National Herald case is part of that.
No, that's
the income
right.
tax authorities haven't given you
a notice.
One second.
Don't be a defense counsel. Now, what I'm trying to say to you is, political vendetta is based not on one single incident. I've told you already, persecution of leaders of the Congress party one by one without any basis. Right? And not only that, the top law officers, when it comes to any Congress any case against the Congress. The top law officers are there. Actually, it's a matter of life and death for them. We observe it every day in court and outside court. Mr. Jaitley, who is the finance minister, keeps on commenting about pending cases. I'm surprised. I mean, we were also ministers. I never commented on a pending case. And this is not the first time that Mr. Jaitley has done it. I remember when the Babri Masjid issue was going on, and the matter is in court for more than 20 years now, he then said that all the accused are innocent. He was also then the minister. So this is their habit. And I'm sorry to say, this is most inappropriate.
But Mr. Sibal, on the National Herald case, has the Income Tax Department issued any notices to the Congress party or...
Mr. Swamy keeps on saying that you are going to get notices.
But has the notice been served?
I don't know. We are surprised.
You're the legal counsel. If a notice had been served, you would know.
One second. Mr. Jaitley is making a statement that this is a wrongdoing. Right? It is a wrongdoing. Naturally, the Income Tax Department will give us notice. Naturally, they'll be enthused if they're finance
minister. For 1.5 years, the notice hasn't come yet to the Congress party, or has it?
Whether the notice has come or not, it is most inappropriate for the finance minister to say this.
My point is, the simple point I'm trying to raise, Mr.
No, first of all, let's talk of criminality. Please tell me who was cheated in this case.
Shanti Bhushan today says
that... No, forget Shanti Bhushan.
Why not? He's now become somebody who's a complainant in this case. Today you questioned that there is no shareholder.
I don't think you know a shareholder.
His father was, and he said that he's in the process of acquiring details and signatures for all the heirs.
For 40 years he didn't bother. If AGL was such a precious company and the shareholding was so precious to him, why did he not become a shareholder for 30 years? Why did they not attend the meeting? Why did he not write to AGL, look, I want to be a shareholder, this is such a great company. And suddenly, because the court has issued notice and there is politics in Shanti Bhushan, suddenly...
So you're saying he's politicizing the entire affair?
I don't want to say anything. He's a senior counsel in the Supreme Court. But you can tell what the motive behind it is.
And
even if Shanti Bhushan is a shareholder, what's the offense? Who has committed the offense? In an offense of cheating, there has to be a victim. Please tell me who the victim is. Subramaniam Swamy?
Public money?
Because it's not public money. What are you saying?
Congress party has raised public money.
So Congress
money.
Party is the victim?
No, it's not the victim.
Who is the victim?
Congress party has raised public money.
So?
That public money has been used and been given to a company, 90 crore worth of...
No. It's been... One thing. Congress party gave money to AGL, not to the company. Please.
Okay.
Don't
to
get
AGL.
The facts right. Huh?
And that so what, 90 crore is converted into...
One thing. What is the, what is the law, which is the law which prohibits it? Please tell me.
According to several experts in the government...
No, forget
it. If there is a change in use, the tax exemption can stand.
What are you saying? Navika, you don't know the facts. I'm sorry.
I'll give you the case of BCCI, stated by the government on several occasions.
One second. No, BCCI has nothing. I was the counsel for BCCI. Again, you are wrong.
Okay.
Let me explain to you.
When they diverted use... One minute. Let me complete the question. Okay. They diverted use of money raised for cricket and used it for football. Their income tax exemption was taken away.
I don't know what you're talking about. Under the Income Tax Act, a political party can earn income from house property, from any other sources. And if you don't believe me, go to Section 13, Capital A of the Income Tax Act.
Election Commission has also given clarification
on that. One second. BJP invested money in CanStar in a mutual fund and went to the Income Tax Department and said my exemption should continue even though I have got dividends.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
BJP also ran a newspaper and they incurred a loss. And they wanted to adjust that loss.
That was also allowed by the BJP.
They ran a newspaper
or a media channel.
It's in the judgment. They may deny anything. It's in the judgment which we cited in court. Then Subramaniam Swamy wrote to the Election Commission saying that, look, under the Representation of People's Act, the resources of a political party can be certainly dealt with. But what about expenditure? And on the 6th of November, the Election Commission wrote to Subramaniam Swamy saying that there is nothing in the Act which prohibits the party from spending the money the way it likes. So if the Election Commission says there is no wrong under any Act, There is no penal provision that affects.
But the Delhi High Court says that there is a criminal intent that...
I'm not saying, I say, which is that section? If I cheat you, you are the victim. So who has cheated whom here? Congressman has not complained. Congressman donated money.
They will not complain. Why will congressmen complain against Rahul Gandhi and Sonia Gandhi?
No congressman. So I have cheated Subramanian Swamy. Now obviously then. Because if the person...
No, but Subramanian Swamy as a private citizen, and that's the contention of the BJP, that it's not political vendetta, because when this case was filed, Subramanian Swamy was not with the BJP.
That's neither the point whether he was not. It is a vendetta by Subramanian Swamy. He's a member of the BJP and the BJP is taking this forward. We all know that. But be that as it may, I still want to know, have I cheated the BJP? Have we cheated the Subramanian Swamy? Who have we cheated?
The fact is, Mr. Kapil Sibal, that in, you know, what everybody understands is that 90 crore rupees was given as a loan by Congress party to a company which was a newspaper company.
Fine.
After which, Young India overnight is turned into a majority.
That's fine.
And in 50 lakhs you get...
So what's that's a normal practice. Incidentally, this is also business practice. I can always assign my loan to somebody else for a lesser amount. I talk to businessmen in this country, they will tell you, Navika, this happens every day.
So where does all the money that comes from the properties and assets, where does it go?
It goes to AGL.
It goes to AGL, which is owned virtually by Young
Indian. What are you saying? AGL can never be owned. The shareholders, owns 99, so the property is never owned. See, please, get your... Ask Mr. Jaitley, he will tell you. AGL owned assets, continues to own assets, even today. No part of those assets can ever be owned, can ever be given to the shareholders of Young Indian.
No, but money earned from those assets, where does that go?
It goes to AGL.
AGL, and AGL is owned by Young Indian.
Please understand, AGL may not own, AGL, Young Indian owns 99% shareholding. But neither Rahul Gandhi, nor Sonia Gandhi, nor any shareholder can get a paisa out of it. No salary, no dividend, no paisa, and you say there is cheating?
So there is no cheating and there is a mountain out of a molehill, yet there is a judgment from the Delhi High Court which
doesn't say that. Judgment says.
My point being that all of this has to be now established in the court of law.
We will do it. No dispute on that.
What happens to Parliament in the interim?
Nothing. Parliament should... Whatever happens in Parliament will be seen in Parliament.
You know, a lot of times it's been said there is a tyranny of numbers. We do see some business being conducted in Lok Sabha, but it's the Rajya Sabha where the Congress has its numbers that is absolutely paralyzed.
Right.
Is this your way of staring back at the government?
It is nothing to do with the National Herald case. It's the kind of politics that the BJP is indulging in, that people are protesting. And for 6 years, the BJP protested. Right? Now why are they shedding crocodile tears?
You're saying the Prime Minister who said that, you know, the poor of this country should be looked at,
we entirely agree with the sentiments of the Prime Minister, and we are touched by the fact that he is so concerned about the common man and the poor. I wish he was as concerned about it when he opposed this very GST for 6 years. I wish he was as concerned.
So you're going to pay him back in the same
Not at all. We want, we have given them proposals on the GST. We are not paying him back at all. In fact, we had a meeting. He had a meeting with us. And we told him, these are our points on the three issues. You please come back to us. And
so you're saying the government needs to come back to you, not the other way around?
They have to, because we've told them what the issues are and what our objections are and how we want a better GST than the one that is, this is present. Their GST is a flawed GST. We want a better GST. What's wrong with that?
Okay, so do you see that entire issue being resolved in the near future?
So that's for the government now to come back to the Congress party, when we'll see.
In the meanwhile, the strategy for Rahul Gandhi, what would your advice to Rahul Gandhi and Sonia Gandhi be when they appear before the lower courts?
That's between a lawyer and a client, not between me and Navika.
No, but this is also a political case.
Maybe so, but it's not public. These are not supposed to be matters to be discussed in the public domain.
But what are you expecting?
As you know,
from
communications between lawyer and client is privileged.
Right. So can we see any breakthrough in the political logjam in Parliament, in the politics of this country?
I'm sure if the government reaches out, because it's their responsibility to run Parliament, there will be a breakthrough if they reach out.
Thank you very much for joining us, Mr. Kapil Sibal. Of course, we do hope people understand the difference between the legal troubles that the Congress seems to be facing at this moment from the political issues that they are raising in Parliament. We'll leave the entire verdict on the people who are watching this interview. Thank you very much for joining us, Mr. Kapil Sibal. That's Navika Kumar signing off from New Delhi.